we're going to talk about expressions with fractions. Now, when dealing with fractions, you have to be extra careful because it's very easy to make a mistake if you're not paying attention. Now, I'm going to start off with one of the most common mistakes I see people make. They look at this and they say, hey, 4x over 4, cancel the 4s, that's just x. They look at this and they say, hey, 4 plus x over 4, cancel the 4s, that's just x. Do these two really look like they'll come out to be the same thing? Let's take a closer look at why we can cancel here. We can write this as just 4 over 4 times x. Of course, 4 over 4, that's just 1. 1 times x, that gives you x. We can cancel here. What about over here? Why can't we just cancel off the 4s and call that x? Or cancel off the 4s and call it 1 plus x? Notice I didn't write either one of those down. I don't like to write wrong stuff down, at least not on purpose. How else can we write this? We can write it as 4 over 4 plus x over 4, the sum of two fractions. Denominators are the same. Keep the denominator, add the numerator, so you get 4 plus x. This is the same as this. And once again, 4 over 4, that's just 1. So we get 1 plus x over 4, and we still have the 4 there. We can't just cancel it away. So here we have multiplication in the numerator. We can cancel, and this is why. Here we have addition in the numerator. We can't just cancel away the 4s, and this is why. And if you didn't understand that, I want you to rewind and watch this again. And if you did understand it, then you're ready for our problems. And here we go. We're going to add some fractions. Now, you know, we can't just cancel the 2 and the 4 here. We have a sum in the numerator. So what we're going to do here, we're adding fractions. We know how to deal with that. We get a common denominator. Our common denominator is going to be 12. So we're going to multiply our first fraction by 3 over 3. Now I'm going to put parentheses around the numerator to remind me that I'm going to multiply the whole numerator by 3. And for the second one, I have to multiply by 4 over 4 to make the denominator 12. And again, parentheses around the numerator to remind me that I'm multiplying the whole numerator by 4. So now I break out my distributive property to multiply this out. 3 times 2, that's 6. 3 times k is 3k. And over here, oh, got to remember my denominator. 3 times 4 is 12. Over here, I'm going to multiply the 4 and the 2k. It's going to give me 8k. And 4 times the minus 1. That gives me a minus 4. And again, 4 times 3, as planned, the denominators are the same. They're both 12. And now I can add them. Since the denominator is the same, all I have to do is add the numerators. 3k plus 8k is 11k. 6 minus 4 is 2. And when I add these two fractions, I get this single fraction down here. Let's try one more. Ooh, we got this extra term out here. What are we going to do about that? Well, we're going to start off getting a common denominator. 2 and 5, the common denominator is going to be 10. And I want to include the 2c, so I'm going to multiply the 2c by 10 over 10 to make it a fraction over 10 as well. Now this one I'm going to have to multiply by 2 over 2. And then this one I'm going to have to multiply by 5 over 5. And all I'm doing here is making all the denominators the same. And notice, I'm going to stick in my parentheses here. So I remember I'm multiplying the entire numerator here by 5. Now here, 10 times 2c is just 20c over 10. Now here it's 2 times 4, that's 8. I'm going to multiply the 8 and distribute that in here. 8 times 5 is 40, and then 8 times minus c is minus 8c. 2 times 5, of course, that's just 10. Now over here, 5 times 9c is 45c, and 5 times 5 is 25. And once again, denominator is 10. As planned, all the denominators are the same, so I can combine these by combining the numerators. I'll have 20c plus 40 minus 8c. Now here's where I have to be careful. I'm subtracting the entire numerator here. We put in the parentheses. You put in the parentheses so that we remember we're subtracting the 45c and the 25 out here. We have to be very careful to watch our signs, especially when dealing with fractions. So we still have our 20c plus 40 minus 8c minus 45c minus 25. We're distributing the negative. And now we see what's happening here. When I subtract this, I'm changing the sign of both the 45c and the 25. Now I can combine all these terms in the numerator, I can combine all the variable terms, and I combine separately, I combine the constant terms. Now, first we'll do the variables. 20c minus 8c, that's 12c. 12c minus 45c is negative 33c. 40 minus 25 is 15. So I can combine all of this into a single fraction, and we're done.